It was a chilling, gruesome crime that shocked the nation. Nearly 21 years ago, June 7th, 1998, three white men in Jasper, Texas, beat an African-American man, this man, James Byrd Jr., and then chained him to the back of a pickup truck, stripped him from the bottom down, and dragged him several miles to his death, his dismembered body abandoned on a dirt road. All three were convicted. One received life in prison, Sean Berry, but the other two received death sentences. And Russell Brewer has already been executed. But tonight, the convicted ringleader, John William King, is set to die by lethal injection. And this brutally racist hate crime and its aftermath have been documented in a film called Two Towns of Jasper.
When we come down that hill walking this way, to be honest with you, I didn't see those drag marks go down this little old logging road. And we started walking, and the further we walked down that road, the more evidence we found. We found the tank top and T-shirt that he was wearing. We found both of his shoes. We found his dentures. And then we found the billfold. Then that's when I knew that it wasn't gonna be a hit-and-run accident. I knew it was a black man that was dead. Hoping that it was a black man that had killed him. But it didn't turn out that way.
Whitney Dow, co-director and co-producer of Two Towns of Jasper, is here with me ahead of this execution tonight. And so just first to you on just justice in this awful, awful case. I mean, you're still in touch with people in Jasper. You were, you know, so deeply entrenched in this whole story. Do you feel the people you're talking to feel like justice is being served?
Some do and some don't. I think it's funny. It's like the film for, you know, those of you who don't know, the film, the way we structured it is that I made it with my partner, Marco Williams, and I lived in town for a year with a white film crew. He's black. He lived in town with a black film crew, and we just interviewed people of our own race and sort of followed the three trials. And so that was because there was such a divide in the community. And of course, the divide is still there. Like, the white community really is not marking this event. They want this all to be in the past. They feel that this is some sort of horrible blot on their community. And I think there's the black community feels like this is finally a measure of justice. You have to remember that James Byrd, I think, was the first black person convicted of killing a white person since the Civil War and given the death penalty. So this was a big, big deal when he got the death penalty.
The families of at least three of Byrd's sisters do plan to attend the execution, is what I've read. Some of his relatives, as you were talking to me in commercial break, they don't want the death penalty. Mm-hmm. Sister Luvon Harris, who is going, is quoted as saying this, quote, "There's closure in a sense that justice was served, but the reality of the impact that is created for a family is that James is gone forever. I don't think anything could close that chapter." You've been talking to people who will be there tonight.
Yes, I think Betty Boatner is going to be speaking at St. Michael's Catholic Church in Jasper tonight. And she really feels like, you know, that she's forgiven Bill a long time ago, that she's a Christian, she believes in forgiveness. And, you know, as her sister says, there's that by taking another life and responding to violence with violence, it's not going to bring James back. And it's just going to, you know, just perpetuate the cycle of violence.
So some, even within the family, aren't in favor of what's about to happen to one of his killers, this ringleader. More on just Jasper, the town itself. I mean, you say it's still incredibly, you know, segregated. Whites stay on their side, blacks stay on their side, and they're seeing this as very different.
Well, I wouldn't say, it's like a lot of places, is that you have I think it's about 53% black and the rest white, mostly white, and that they mingle. When I was there, there's black Jasperites who were on the city council. There's a black mayor. And so they would meet in public places. But when I lived there for that year and Marco lived there, it's a town of 7,000 people. It's a really small town.
Yeah.
And Marco and I never saw each other. That's how separated it was. So, and really the response to the reason why I wanted to make the film is when we first went down there and started talking to people, there was such a different sense of what this crime meant to the community. And
how by, do you mean?
Is that I think for the white community, they had this sense that this was something like a bolt of lightning from heaven. And in fact, many people said to me that God had chosen Jasper because it was so righteous to have it happen there, that they were the only community had strong enough faith to sustain it. And the black community said, this is just another spot on the continuum. White people have been killing black Americans and black people in Texas and the South for years with no consequences. And the only thing different about this is that they're actually going to charge him and that the news media was there.
Just last question. Can you just tell us a little bit more about James Byrd?
I didn't know James Byrd. Obviously, I came to it. And I think that, you know, it was actually interesting because that was also interesting of how the white people talked about James Byrd. And that was actually one of the reasons why I originally went down to it, is that the black community knew him as a part of this big family in Jasper, and that was very sort of involved with each other. And the white community always said, well, you know, he was the town drunk or he had these problems. They always wanted to sort of frame him as someone that was kind of outside of the community. And so I didn't know him, so I can't speak to him. I can't speak to it directly.
Sure. But obviously, a huge night tonight, and you know, as you've been in touch with people, maybe we'll talk to someone tomorrow. But it's just it's always just noteworthy on an execution story such as this that some people in his own family just aren't even in favor of what some see as clearly justice.
And I think for Americans,
quickly, yeah.
So for Americans, I think that you have to remember this took in the last. This happened in 1998. And I think it was so hard. It wasn't just an event for Black Americans. It's a horrible event for as white Americans.
Yeah.
Sort of seeing that this crime harkened back to horrible lynchings that happened before, and we didn't believe that could still happen, and that was part of our.
But
society.
It did, as recent as 1998.
Yeah.
Whitney Dow, thank you so much for
thank
coming
you.
Through.